In a landmark verdict, the Supreme Court today pronounced that privacy is a constitutional right. 9 judges decided this unanimously. Though they cited different reasons for their conclusion, the verdict is a major setback for the government, which had argued that the Constitution does not guarantee individual privacy as an inalienable fundamental right. Mirror Now spoke to Soli Surabji, former Attorney General of India, who was of the opinion that although right to privacy is a fundamental right, it is not absolute in nature. Listen in.
That privacy is a fundamental right, correct? Now, any fundamental right cannot be absolute. It can be subject to reasonable restrictions. What are reasonable restrictions depends on the nature of the restriction placed. Is it excessive? Is it disproportionate? So that would have to be future actions and policies of the government would have to be judged in the light of the principles laid down in the judgment. But there cannot be any universal rule that because of the judgment, Aadhaar is bad. No. All depends what the provisions are. And would it really infringe the right to privacy to the extent that go beyond the requirements of the situation? There may be certain cases in which privacy can be justifiably restricted. And you talk about income tax. It all depends. At what stage? What are the proceedings? What is required? Because there is no privacy when it comes to revenue matters. I mean, to some extent, I say. And their person can't say, oh, because of the right to privacy, I want to answer questions which are legitimately asked by the income tax department. It can't be a broad shield for silence, this judgment. It all depends on the nature of the decision. I don't think anyone can really invoke the right to privacy and say, I won't answer questions which are legitimately asked by the income tax department or any other department. So to that extent, it can't be a sheet, it can't be an answer for a person to say, I'll keep quiet, I won't answer. My privacy is involved. No. Privacy is subject to other considerations, subject to national interest, subject to revenue considerations. The main thing is, the crux of the matter is, the restriction must not be excessive, must not be disproportionate. And that's a good thing, it's a very good protection the judgment gives. And remember, as is very well said, the right to be let alone is one of the most fundamental rights in any civilized society. And the right to be let alone is inherent in the very personality of the individual. And that's what the judgment is recognized.
Meanwhile, listen into how opposition has taken this opportunity to hit out at BJP government.
The Congress Party welcomes the unanimous judgment of the Supreme Court declaring that right to privacy is a fundamental right. The Aadhaar that we had conceived was perfectly compatible with the right to privacy. Aadhaar was conceived as an administrative tool in order to ensure that benefits reach the targeted people. It's not Aadhaar that is inconsistent with the right to privacy. It's the interpretation of this government of Article 21, which is an invasion of the right to privacy. It is the current government which argued that there is no fundamental right to privacy. Today, we can once again celebrate our freedom. Tomorrow, there will be other challenges, other questions, and other attempts to invade the right to privacy. We shall overcome those challenges too.
Supreme Court's decision on treating right to privacy as a fundamental right is a seminal decision. It's a path-breaking decision. Congress Party welcomes this decision. It's a defeat of Modi government and all those forces who said right of privacy cannot be part of fundamental right, for it is not mentioned in the Constitution. Supreme Court has rejected that argument of Modi government and BJP government.
My colleague Meenakshi gives us more details on the judgment. Listen in.
Well, at the outset, you know, let me begin by saying that the impact of this judgment will be felt hugely in the 377 case. And the reason we are being so definite about it is because page 125, para 128 of this judgment, which contains the consolidated opinion of four judges. It has been penned by Justice Chandrachud, but it has the consenting view of Honorable Chief Justice of India, along with his two other brother judges, has made a scathing attack on the finding of the Supreme Court judgment, which had set aside the 2007 Delhi High Court ruling on homosexuality. Essentially, if I can quickly read out from this particular portion, which we have quoted for our viewers, the invasion of a fundamental right is not rendered tolerable when a few, as opposed to a large number of persons, are subject to hostile treatment. Chilling effect on the exercise of the right poses grave danger to unhindered fulfillment of one's sexual orientation as an element of privacy and dignity. Hence the rationale that the prosecution of few can't be index or violation is flawed. This is a scathing indictment by the superior strength bench of the Supreme Court's own judgment, which was an inferior strength bench judgment, which had gone ahead and set aside the 2007 Delhi High Court ruling, which had permitted decriminalizing of Section 377, which is homosexuality. So one, this is going to add a lot of might going forward, as Anjali Gopalan was reiterating, when the 377 matter is heard by the curative bench. The curative bench, remember, is to hear the matter again. It is still pending. It's not been constituted. So when that matter comes up for hearing in the foreseeable future, this right to privacy judgment, this particular noting, is going to be quoted by lawyers to showcase as to how there was a cure in the earlier two judge bench judgment of the Supreme Court on the issue of 377.
In fact, BJP leader Subramaniam Swamy spoke about the effects of this judgment on various crucial issues like Aadhaar, homosexuality and the beef ban, specifically pointing out that public display of affection amongst homosexuals will not be tolerated.
New Attorney General did set the record straight by saying that fundamental rights, it is a fundamental right subject to reasonable restrictions. Yes, that was the earlier position, but we did change our stand, and I'm glad we did. And the earlier stand was based on the 1962 judgment of eight judges, and they just carried it forward because they know that, there was a feeling that this, if it becomes a fundamental right, it will adversely impact Aadhaar. It's bound to affect Aadhaar. Aadhaar has to undergo a major surgery now. So will GST also have to rectify its GST and structure. Otherwise, it will be subject to striking down on the question of privacy. 377, if somebody does it in his bedroom, nobody will know about it. But any public display of homosexuality or lesbianism will be struck down and in fact would be part of 377, because it's a genetic flaw according to us, and it cannot be celebrated. We will not allow a public demonstration of kissing and holding hands and getting married and so on. The section 377 will not be affected at all, and the reasonable restrictions on its lack of public display would be a reasonable restriction. Well, if it's in the constitution that you should ban the slaughter of cows, then we have a restriction. If there is a thing that you eat which will make you sick, or make you mad or become ruin your health, like cocaine, yes, there'll be restrictions. Disorderly behavior due to drinking, well, there'll be restrictions. Those are all have to be done, fine-tuned, and the court is the final authority. But to say that there's an absolute right that has been given to you, no. There's no absolute right for privacy. It is subject to reasonable restriction. What is reasonable will be decided by the courts.
Let's get you the voices of the petitioner Rajiv Chandrasekhar, Bear Giant Panda, and original petitioner in the case, Justice K.S. Puttaswamy, who in fact filed the case in 2012.
I have been maintaining from 2013 onwards. I started this fight from 2013. It started in the context of Aadhaar, but it became much more relevant as more and more of our digitization of our economy has taken place, that consumers of India do not have adequate protection against the misuse of the data, the information, and their own the pervasive intrusion of technology into their lives. So it was important that that privacy be established as a fundamental right. Unfortunately, some people in our bureaucratic and otherwise system were continuing to insist that privacy was not a fundamental right and the state had an absolute right, or private companies were not obliged, had no obligations vis-a-vis data and information of consumers. So I'm glad that the Supreme Court has ruled on this petition. This petition had a number of petitioners. I was a petitioner in this petition as well. And this is what I had argued, that privacy is a fundamental right. It is not an absolute right. It can be subject to some restrictions, but there cannot be any doubt that an Indian, under the Constitution, an Indian citizen enjoys right to free speech subject to restrictions, must also enjoy right to privacy under some restrictions.
So you are one of the petitioners, the first petitioners as far as the right to privacy is concerned. And today clearly we see the Supreme Court has upheld the right to privacy as a fundamental right. Now, what is your reaction?
See, actually, sir, I'm very happy. Are you not happy? Everybody is happy. That nobody is affected by this. And it seems Supreme Court has come to the rescue of private citizens and has upheld, see, a 8-month judgment which had held that it is a private right has been overruled, and the Supreme Court has held that it is a public right.
Right.
Privacy is a fundamental right.
Right.
So all are happy.
Okay, so the center's intention to make Aadhaar mandatory was for availing social welfare services.
Aadhaar card is a different issue, madam.
Okay.
Of course, it has some connection, but it is dependent on its own. It can be, I do not know how the government will defend it and what will be the outcome of it.
What this ruling will do will establish that since privacy is a fundamental right, now laws will have to be put into place so that there will be specific obligations on, in my bill I call them data handlers and data controllers. So whether they are private companies or they are social media apps or platforms or they are government agencies, there will be obligations about how they can handle their data. Informed consent of citizens will be required. And if the privacy of the data is violated, then there should be specific punishments and the laws will have to be drafted to make sure all this is put into place. So it is not black or white. We can have modern technologies and the digital economy, and yet we can have a right to privacy with very narrowly defined exceptions for national security or with our consent.
Some reactions coming in from the legal fraternity.
सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने आज एक बहुत ऐतिहासिक फैसले में ये बोला है कि निजता का अधिकार यानी कि प्राइवेसी का अधिकार एक मौलिक अधिकार है और संविधान के अनुच्छेद 21 के तहत आता है और आगे अभी कुछ नहीं बोला है कि भाई आधार एक्ट वैध है कि अवैध है वो तो एक छोटी खंडपीठ के सामने जाएगा 9 जजों की खंडपीठ ने पुराने जो फैसले थे जिसमें कहीं कहीं ये लिखा था कि भाई ये राइट टू प्राइवेसी मौलिक अधिकार नहीं है उसको ओवररूल कर दिया है बोला है कि मौलिक अधिकार है इसका ये मतलब है कि अब अगर सरकार कोई कानून बनाती है जैसे आधार का कानून बनाया है जिसमें ये बोला है कि अभी तो ये बोला है कि सोशल वेलफेयर स्कीम्स के लिए आधार नंबर देना होगा इनकम टैक्स के लिए आधार नंबर देना होगा ये तो एक बात है इसको अब देखा जाएगा कि भाई ये एक रीजनेबल कानून है कि नहीं जो कि रीजनेबल रिस्ट्रिक्शन आपके मौलिक अधिकार पर लगाता है अगर मान लीजिए कल को सरकार ये बोले कि भाई आप जहां ट्रैवल करते हैं रेलवे रिजर्वेशन के लिए एयरलाइन रिजर्वेशन के लिए आप जो खरीदते हैं उसके लिए भी आपको आधार नंबर देना होगा और ये सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन सरकार के पास जाएगी। तो ऐसे कानून को अनरीजनेबल रिस्ट्रिक्शन आपके प्राइवेसी के मौलिक अधिकार पर माना जाएगा और उसको, मेरी राय ये है कि उसको स्ट्राइक डाउन कर दिया जाएगा। लेकिन अभी तक जो आधार एक्ट है वो तो सिर्फ आधार को सोशल वेलफेयर स्कीम्स और इनकम टैक्स एक्ट में इनकम टैक्स रिटर्न के लिए लाजमी किया गया है। ये छोटी खंडपीठ देखेगी।
Let's also listen into some political reactions coming in on the judgment.
I'm delighted at the judgment. I had no doubt in my mind whatsoever that given the Apex Court's total commitment to upholding fundamental rights and right to human dignity, they will hold a right to privacy as a fundamental right. And I have always argued that right to privacy is part of the rights that inhere in each human being as a person. The Constitutional Court, I'm proud to say, has kept faith with the constitutional morality and has kept faith with the aspirations of the people of India.
Absolute rights. Their enjoyment can be regulated by a law made by the parliament, and therefore reasonable restrictions can always be placed. Therefore, I think that it's a very significant judgment because it upholds the right of an individual, a citizen, being master of his own body and mind.
So in a landmark verdict, the Supreme Court today pronounced that privacy is a constitutional right. 9-judge bench decided this, though they cited different reasons for their conclusion. The verdict is a major setback for the government, which had argued that the Constitution does not guarantee individual privacy as an inalienable fundamental right. Well, that's all we have for now. More news and updates on the other side. Stay tuned to Mirror Now.